So, I know what you're thinking. A doll? Well, Monster Hill High dolls aren't your normal dolls. We're first looking at Operetta, whose dad happens to be Phantom of the Opera, standing in the 12-inch scale. This doll is amazing. Sporting red and black hair. Her face mask does come off. They've even sculpted it. I'm leaving the band. So, okay, on her face, to be true to her father, who is also scarred for life on the right side of his face. They turned around and sculpted it into her face. They've sculpted it. All musical notes and symbols on her right side of the face instead of being scarred like her father in the cruel accident at the opera where he decided to hide. Her mask happens to be the quarter note shaped like a heart, which is dripping, held in place. There is a little comb that clips into her hair. I highly recommend if you get her, keep the rubber band, the clear rubber band. You don't really notice it. And it holds the mask perfectly. Her earrings, one side, happens to be the black dice. On the other side, and she doesn't want to stay, is a dice-shaped guitar. All throughout her body There is the musical notes on her right arm. They're tattooed with hearts and the sheet music. Even her belt is some musical notes with a musical note chain hanging off the side. Her jacket has some of the little piano keys, and she has a pick for a ring. Her skin tone is a light purple, wearing the white musical note jacket highlighted with piano keys underneath, which you can open up for those who are scared. It's a simple little clear clasp to open up to a purple and black shirt. She's sporting some jeans in capri style and wearing black and white wedge style boots. She comes with a few accessories as well. First, all the Monster High dolls do come with a diary that looks just like a composition pad, giving you her name and a little look into her life. And it looks like her diary's taking place during the summer, going from July all the way to August 31st. On the back, there's a little bit about me. She's 16 years old in phantom years, so we have to try and figure out what that means. Monster parent, like I said, Phantom of the Opera. Her flaws, her killing style. She goes on to talk about her pet, which we'll see shortly, Memphis Big Daddy-O. Her favorite thing is playing music. And she does come up with a guitar coffin. And just like any teenager, the biggest pet peeve, I don't like being told what to do. No, quite a few of those. She loves music. Her least favorite is science. Her favorite color is vintage red velvet. Surprised that's not her favorite food, but she must be a fan of Elvis Presley because she loves fried peanut butter and banana sandwiches. And her BFFs, Holt Hyde, who happens to be the son of Mr. Hyde, and Deuce Gorgon. She also comes with a few accessories. She comes with a brush with the Monster High emblem on it. You can see I've already brushed her hair because it was so flat. Here's her pet, Memphis Daddy-O Longlegs. Can tell a little bit of an Elvis Presley vibe with the hair. Goes with her favorite sandwich. And her coffin guitar, which does open up. So here's the coffin guitar. You can see they even did the cutouts as if it was a real guitar. Does open up where you can put her little trinkets in there. And even the guitar strap has the Monster Hill High embossed on the strap, and where it connects we see the 3D skull. And like with all Monster High dolls, they do come with stands. So why should I look at Monster High? I'm an action figure girl. Come on, I hate Barbie, but these dolls, yes, I said the D word, dolls, are really cool. And I don't mind going into the pink aisle looking for them. With 10 points of articulation, this doll has a lot more than Barbie's did when I was growing up. The head does go around 360. Nothing unusual there. The arms are on ball joints, giving you a full range of motion. You got a nice swivel with each of the elbows and wrist joints. So you can really get the attitude that these dolls deserve. You don't have anything at the waist. Sorry. That seemed to only be with action figures. But yes, does bend. And you can do some splits. But Operetta is not a cheerleader. So that didn't mind. Her clothes do come off very easily. They're all Velcroed on, so you can easily undress her, boys. And if you want the cheerleader, yes, they do have a cheerleading costume out there for the Monster Hill dolls. And her clothes are all Velcroed on. Her belt is a simple snap. One tip, boys, make sure she's standing straight up when you're getting the Velcro on. Otherwise, it will pop. Her shoes do come off. They slide off. I mean, these are really cool shoes. Look at the heel. It is actually a G-clef. So it's not the typical black and white cheerleading shoes that you would normally see. They brought them up into modern age. And it's pretty cool that this whole line takes inspiration from horror films. And I grew up loving horror flicks. In fact, one of the first Broadway plays I got to see was Phantom of the Opera. So when I saw her in the toy aisle, all I kept seeing was that chandelier coming crashing down in the theater and saying, I've got to get this doll, that it's reminding me of that experience. And I can't wait to see the other ones.
So the same way. The only way I can express my emotions is through my music. I'm just so touched by your story. would be my